together with me. First thing first.
First thing first.
Yes, that's right. So this technique will assist us, yeah, dia akan assist kita untuk prioritize our task. Because most of us always say that, "Oi, banyaknya kerja, I tak boleh cope lah." Betul ke you tak boleh cope? Ataupun you actually are not prioritizing, eh? Tidak meletakkan priority yang betul kepada tugasan yang diberikan kepada anda, ya. Eh? Jadi, my dear friends, this is what we're going to do, eh? Right? This is how we actually prioritize, eh? So nanti Aiman, please underline, eh? Ataupun laser pointer, point yang saya nak share ni. Okay, one of the way to prioritize is to list down all your tasks, activities and projects that you need to do. That's first thing, yeah. Okay, sebab dari nanti daripada situ kita boleh identify, yeah. And then the second one, assign importance to each of the activities, yeah. Anda dah list down semua perkara yang anda perlu laksanakan, dan nanti kita akan segregate. Nanti saya akan share seperti bagaimana nak segregate, yeah, using four time quadrant. And then once you have assigned important to each activity, evaluate, yeah. So this is how we are going to evaluate, yeah. Right, thank you. Okay. So let's go to the next slide. Thanks. Okay. Four time quadrants ni dia terbagi kepada empat, eh. Okay, kita ada, I'm just going to straight away show to you the quadrant, eh. Okay, nanti saya akan explain. Okay, four time quadrant, dia ada empat. Siap-siap dah terus pergi dekat lompat kat aktiviti, eh. Dah tahulah maknanya lepas ni anda kena buat, eh. We have one. We have two. We have three, and we have four. Eh? Now, the first quadrant, eh, it is urgent and important. Okay, quadrant two, important, not urgent. Right, quadrant three, urgent, not important. Quadrant four, not urgent, not important. Alright, so untuk kita punya four time quadrant ni, I'm going to focus more on this part, eh? This part. Let me just share with you how to prioritize your tasks. Okay. Quadrant one, bila sesuatu task dia jatuh dalam quadrant one, which is urgent and important, that means, eh, masuk di sini, anda kena stop doing everything, terus settlekan urgent dan important ni. Terus settlekan quadrant one. That means this quadrant one, if it happens, you have to stop doing anything, focus to accomplish this task. So kategori yang masuk dalam quadrant one ni, kategori berapa? Kategori one, eh? Baru one, eh? Ada lagi three. This only falls for situation that is emergency. Involve safety. Involve risk. Okay, let me give you example. Yeah. Okay. Sekiranya di tempat kerja anda, bila anda mendengar bunyi alarm kebakaran, what do you do?
Lari.
Lari ke mana tu?
Ke tempat berkumpul. Pergi ke tempat berkumpul.
Betul. Saya kalau sebagai marshal di tempat kerja Cik Amirul, saya merasa sangat lega ya. Sebab ada lari-lari dia main lari-lari. Dia lagi pusing-pusing je dalam department tu. Stress ni macam kat situ ya. So itu contoh dia. When if you hear the fire alarm, the very first thing that you need to do is to save yourself. Betul ya? Tinggalkan. Tak ada kalau yang wanita tu tak yang makeup tu dia lari terus keluar turun tangga pergi dekat kawasan assemble. Lepas tu dah sampai dekat assemble tu ada marshal ya, bukan marshal A ni, dia marshal untuk fire drill ke fire emergency, dia dah bagi tahu okey beratur kat mana, ada signage ya. So that is part of urgent and important. Okay, now saya bagi contoh lagi. Saya bagi contoh diri saya lah senang eh. My situation eh. Okay, all this while I've been working with a bank eh. The last bank was OSK Investment Bank. It's investment bank. And my task, okay, one of the task is to take care of premier banking punya clients eh. So premier banking clients ni minimum saving or minimum investment they have in their account is 1 million. 1 million ringgit Malaysia ya. Eh? In case ada tepi, kalau 1 million rupiahnya, 1 juta rupiahnya, nilainya berapa aja? Okay, 1 million ringgit Malaysia ya. Eh? Okay, so you can imagine that category of group. Dia punya mindset bagaimana ya. Eh? So, as the advisor yeah, of handling portfolio for this category of clients, kalau pagi-pagi saya bangun, saya dapat berita, tak payah pagi-pagi lah. Malam tu kalau saya dah dapat tahu ada satu info that the market will crash. Because somebody important in the economy, pita ataupun pengsan. Semata-mata tengah jalan-jalan minum makan aiskrim, dia pengsan. Contohnya orang buffet, tengah-tengah minum kopi, tiba-tiba dia pengsan. Oh, market will crash. So there and then, I have to restructure portfolio client saya. Itu ada kena-mengena dengan risk. Okay. So far so good?
Good, good.
Yes. Anything that will jeopardize the safety of your organization, the country ataupun your department, itu boleh masuk urgent and important. Maknanya bila berlaku je ni, you kena buat. You kena settlekan. For instance, let's say kalau anda dalam IT. Sekali dapat berita, you punya company system is being hacked. And then telah diserang dengan virus. Menyebabkan semua data-data dicuri. As an IT team or cyber attack team safety. Apa macam-macam nama ada sekarang kan? That is your quadrant one. Maknanya kalau anda tengah bos rupak macam-macam, you drop the whole thing, settle ni dulu. Kalau macam finance, dapat berita, you tengok financial statement, analyze it. Somebody has been taking money, one ringgit every day, and it has been happening for the past 30 years. Itu aja. Nampak eh maksud saya di sini? That means your daily task tak ada, tak boleh ada di hari-hari. Melainkan anda adalah tentera yang menjaga sempadan. Everything is urgent, it's important because at any time somebody can shoot you. So far so good? Gelap ni satu eh. Sebab semua ada, banyak kecil lah. Ya, I tak ada merasa lah pun bagaimana kerja lah semua nak kena buat. Yalah tu, semua you letak kat sini. Besok migraine lah, 3 bulan kerja rambut dah tak ada. Kerja apa tu? Okay, kerja potong rambut. Okay, that is quadrant 1. Now, let's move on to quadrant 2 eh. So, quadrant 2 ni, urgent, apa, important not urgent. Senang saya kategorikan macam ni. Everything. Semua yang dalam you punya job description eh, should fall in quadrant 2. Kenapa saya cakap dalam quadrant 2? Bila you start kerja, it could be your personal or your professional task. Eh? Bila you dapat letter offer, dia dah tulis kat situ. This is what you need to do and you have to submit it within 2 weeks time. You dah tahu dia punya deadline. Ini bukan ad hoc. Eh? Ad hoc tak ada dalam ni. You dah tahu you kena buat. Anything is in your job description that is quadrant 2. So, according to full-time quadrant, ini you kena fokus. Sebab bila ini you tak fokus, dia akan termasuk kat sini. Sebab dia tu deadlines. Saya beri contoh, kalau anda dalam, okay, let's say IT lah, you have a timeline, you have to check server ke, you have to check the equipment yeah, in your organization every month. Dua kali ke tiga kali. Bila tak buat tu, dah tak sempat, dia akan jadi gila. Oh, anda dalam HR. HR, okay, kena prepare payroll. Masuk je minggu ketiga, one week before end of the month, anda dah kena prepare payroll. Maknanya, voucher dah kena get ready. You dah kira commission, dah finalize dengan finance. So, you already know what need to be done. So, you can prepare early. Tu maksud dia, quadrant 2. Important, but you don't have to do it there and then because you dah tahu deadline dia bila. Jadi, you structure it. Mana yang kena submit dulu, you buat tu dulu. Or some of you in the morning, kalau anda dalam corporate call, pagi-pagi saya memang kena check email. Sebab apa sahaja, it could be cerita gosip ke, grapevine ke, that can impact the image of my organisation, I kena take action. So, checking email tu, you dah tahu itu quadrant 2 juga. Masuk je kerja, itu you buat dulu. Nampak? Nampak the difference? Sebab saya pernah dulu, saya dengan saya punya team kan, nama dia Faiz. Okay, Kelly in the morning, okay, hi Faiz. Please complete this, I need it, I need it now. Lepas tu tak lama, setengah jam tu saya approach si Faiz ni lagi. Okay Faiz, okay, this one also is important urgent, I need it today. Lepas tu tak lama lah, tu jam saya datang lagi dia, Faiz tu, wait, Maria This is, I'm getting confused now. Please let me know which one is important, urgent. Which one I can, important, but not urgent. That means, dia nak tahu, mana yang you nak, I submit before end of the day. Mana yang you nak, I submit pagi-pagi esok. Mana yang I boleh submit kemudian, last kali. If everything is important and urgent, yang mana satu important, yang mana satu urgent, dia tanya. Okay. So we always get stressed out bila kita, everything kita letak kat sini. No. You fulfill this first. Okay. Supaya jelas eh. Now let's go to quadrant 3. Okay. Pandai kamera, tepuk pipi. Bangun sikit lagi. Alright. Quadrant 3 ni, dia tulis kat sini, urgent, not important. Okay. As saya simplify it in this manner ya. Anything in your organisation, okay, contoh. Saya bagi contoh dulu, sorry. Saya bagi contoh. Okay, dekat you punya organisation ada tandas? Di pejabat anda ada tandas?
Ada.
Ada, thank you Nisa. Yang lain-lain tu tandas?
Ada.
Ada tandas ya? Ada. Nisa je yang jawab. Yang lain tu kan tandas ke? Dah lama ada. Adalah, kenalah ada tanda.
Cinta pokok.
Yasin pergi. Itulah tanda dia, Yasin. Pokok. Saya gurau Yasin. Now, okay, soalan saya, kalau tandas di office anda, di pejabat anda, rosak, satu tandas rosak, ada lagi satu tandas, betul?
Betul.
Betul sahabat. Kalau tempat kerja anda hanya ada satu tandas untuk semua yang ada kat situ, nak dekat 50 orang tu, silalah cari pekerjaan lain. Sangat berbahaya. Tandas hanya ada satu untuk 50 orang kerana pokok dah tidak banyak sekarang. Okay. So maksud saya di sini, okay, satu tandas rosak, mungkin ada lagi 4 tandas yang boleh digunakan. Business as usual still can run. Betul? Business as usual. Ataupun sekarang ada dia punya akronim, nama dia bau kan? Atau anda pergi shopping mall, escalator rosak. Satu escalator rosak, mall masih boleh dibuka pengunjung masih boleh datang ke mall tu kerana ada eskalator lain yang boleh digunakan. So contoh itu is quadrant 3. It could be housekeeping. Yeah. It could be replying to email your colleagues. Depending lah, depend ya. Yeah. You still have to do it, but you will settle this first because ni memang your core task. Then baru you tengok kat sini. Baru you tengok apa lagi. Tapi selalunya macam housekeeping, yeah. And then getting back to people which is not related to quadrant 2. That could be quadrant 3. Business can still run as usual walaupun anda tak siapkan topik apa perkara tersebut, ya. Yeah? You can still, business can still run. However, ha, ada however kat situ, macam housekeeping ni, you still have to do it, ya. Yeah? But if you are in certain departments like HR, finance, housekeeping or filing is quadrant 2. But for certain department, housekeeping or administration filing could be quadrant 3. Yeah? Kalau tidak, nanti jadi macam certain industri atau file ada file, atas file ada file, atas file atas ada file, atas tu file tu bermula daripada atas meja. So atas meja ada file, atas file yang atas meja tu ada file apa. At the end of the day, bila you masuk bilik orang tu, you pun takut. Sebab you takut file tu jatuh kat muka you. You can't even see the person who's sitting at the table. File tu lebih tinggi daripada dia. Okay. So that is quadrant 3. Quadrant 4. Not urgent. Not important. Anything that has got no related to your work is quadrant 4. Simple as tomorrow is pay day for shopping. Nasib baik hari Ahad. Tapi kepada mereka yang bekerja hari Ahad, mungkin mereka akan fokus kepada shopping. You can do it later. And of course, gossiping out of the question. Yeah? So, quadrant 4 ni nak yang tak ada mengena dengan kerja tu, memang dia tak akan enhance you punya performance. Just put quadrant 4. But let me emphasize here, yeah? exercise plus learning. This two is quadrant 2. Okay. Kenapa saya letak exercise di quadrant 2? Anybody would like to guess? Okay, tak apa. Saya tanya, saya jawab. Untuk menjimatkan masa. Mungkin all of you. Tak apalah, Maria. You cakap. I tulis. I dengar. Okay. Exercise ni. Alright. Kalau yang selalu kita dengar, seminggu exercise berapa kali?
4 kali.
4 kali. Baguslah. Okay. Dia 3 to 4 times. Eh. Okay. Sekali exercise berapa minit?
30 minit.
30 minit. Thank you. That's it. Okay. Now, if so you know, macam yang tadi saya cerita, quadrant 2, you know the schedule macam mana. 3 to 4 times a week, 30 minutes eh, every time you exercise. Okay. Kalau you tak buat exercise, lama-lama, you jatuh sakit. Okay. Jatuh sakit, lepas tu you punya doktor. So doktor pun cakap, okay, kolesterol you tinggi lah. Kolesterol you tinggi. Mulai sekarang, walaupun apa yang terjadi, anda kena exercise setiap hari. Kalau you tak exercise, nanti you akan tiba-tiba pitam. So you nampak, whether you like it or not, you have to do it. Every day. Specific hours. Can you see? What exercise, why I put exercise in quadrant 2? You tak buat, it will cause you, will cause your health. Tu dia. And how about learning? Somebody put learning ni quadrant 3. Eh? Learning, you can't put it quadrant 3 because it's a continuous process. You attend training ke, you baca buku ke, you have to do it For my suggestion, at least monthly. Upgrade your skills, anything to sharpen your skills. It is always quadrant two. Sebulan sekali, you attend training. Contoh, sebulan sekali, you complete baca buku related to the field that you want to master. Sebulan sekali, you baca self-development book to enhance your positivity. Because our mind needs information. Our mind sebenarnya suka membaca. Dia suka ilmu. So, kalau you tak continuously learning, nanti you boleh kena Alzheimer. Dementia. Nampak? So, when this happen, you pun jumpa doktor. Doktor cakap mulai sekarang, you kena hari-hari baca buku. Satu page. Dah, dia akan jadi quadrant one. Do you see how that quadrant, this exercise and learning can be quadrant one if you don't take care of it? Eh? So, sebab tu, dia mesti di quadrant dua.